I have coated with clay, and that clay coating keeps the hot glass from sticking to the metal rod. So when I start winding the glass on there, I can eventually take it off. Now, glass that I use comes from Murano, Italy. It comes in all kinds of awesome colors. You just decide what color you want to play with and heat it up. Now, black is really deep purple. You can see that. Isn't that cool?
Mm-hmm.
Now, when I introduce the glass to the flame, you get this bright yellow light. That's because glass has sodium in it. The sodium comes from the fact that those Italians in Murano figured out early on that if they put potash in the glass, it would help make it clear. And that took some of the nice impurities out of it. So, when you melt the glass, you get a sodium flare. I have glasses that I wear that keep me from seeing that sodium flare, and there's some glasses for you, sir. Just flip them right on over your glasses, and that light will disappear. Now, what we're going to do here is we're going to take the glass, we're going to heat it to the temperature of a volcanic lava flow. If you think about where glass comes from, it's actually mostly from volcanic activity. There's some dirt on it, and that I'm just going to let it drop. I get the glass that close to 2,000 degrees, and then I just start winding it on that metal rod. Like you wind up spaghetti on a fork, or if you had honey on the knife, you didn't want your honey to drip off your knife, that's what you do. Just keep turning it like that. Turn this down a little bit, and got it good and warm. Now, the Egyptians were the first people to make glass beads, and they think what they were doing is they were melting metal in a pit in the sand. Got the sand so hot that the glass and the silica and the sand fused together. So when they cleaned out their sand pits, they realized they had a new material. They figured out if they packed that around anvil dung or clay and heated it up, they could make a small bead. Now, what I'm doing now is I'm taking advantage of the fact that glass is really a frozen liquid, and it freezes around 1,000 degrees, so we call it a super cool liquid. Now, I take that little string of glass that I just pulled out there and let freeze, and I use that to draw my design on my bead. And here we go. Now, that design disappears as it goes, but it will come back as it cools. Now, I've got the design on there. I want to change the profile, so I'll just squish it. That's a technical term. And now you can take your glasses off. You'll be able to see the design that I drew in the bead.
So how do you pull it off of there?
Well, right now we're going to let it cool. But eventually what will happen is we will stick that in water, that clay will soften up, and then that bead will slide right off. But in the meantime, it goes into a kiln. Because what happens with glass is as it cools, it contracts. And the outside cools faster than the inside, so it's squeezing down on the middle of that bead and causing stress to build up. So that will make that bead fragile and it will break easily. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold it at 950 degrees. That's going to let the molecules in the glass find their way back to where they belong, because that temperature, they were boogieing just as fast as they could boogie. And I went, freeze tag. So now we need them to slow dance. So at 950, that's what we're doing. We're slow dancing, we're finding our partner and settling in. And then tonight, we'll cool it down 100 degrees an hour. And that keeps that squeeze from happening, makes that bead extremely strong. And that's called the annealing process. If I don't do that, the bead will be fragile, it'll break easily.
Yeah.